3, 2, 1, los. 6 rechts, 50.
Hi all, this is Mike from Wanderschikane TV. Today we'll be optimizing Dirt Rally 2 for use in virtual reality with OpenXR Toolkit and Open Composite. On top, we will use an eye accommodation fix to give yourself a more realistic representation of lighting in nature. Also, Dirt Rally 2 is really demanding and therefore don't expect to get 90 frames per second all of the time, which would be the optimum frame rate for the HP Reverb G2. I must say, I couldn't get rid of all the stutters within the game, but I noticed that it seems that stuttering seems to be less noticeable when the game is installed on a SSD drive rather than on a hard disk drive. So, make sure to install the game on a SSD or move it from within Steam to such a drive. In this video, for the first time, I will be using OBS for recording from virtual reality with a new plugin from Jabber. And this allows us also to project the frame rate counter right away into the videos, so that you get some impression about the frames per seconds, any hiccups in my showcase videos, the CPU and the GPU headroom. As for the settings, we will be going through multiple settings, including NVIDIA driver, Open Composite, settings for the eye accommodation fix, in-game settings and OpenXR Toolkit settings. All of them are contributing to much improved performance of Dirt Rally 2 in VR. As usual, if you like the content of the video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel to further support my work. And now, let's have a look at the rest of the showcases and afterwards follow carefully the settings. Enjoy the video!
Macht auf! 120!
Let's go to the NVIDIA settings. Right click on the desktop, show more options, and select NVIDIA control panel. In the help menu, in the system information, you can see that I'm here on driver version 522.25 on RTX 3080. Close it. Select manage 3D settings on the left, switch here to program settings, and select Dirt Rally 2 from this drop-down here. Here are my settings. Anisotropic filtering is set to 4 times. Anti-aliasing mode to override any application setting. Anti-aliasing setting 2 times. Power management mode, prefer maximum performance. Texture filtering and isotropic sample option off. Texture filtering negative LOD bias clamp. And otherwise everything on default. If you change something, press apply to take over the changes. Let's have a look at the OpenXR tools for Windows Mixed Reality. You can see within them, everything is set to default. So the preview is here set to off. We're not using a custom rendering scale. And basically, that's already it here. Just leave everything. We will set these settings via OpenXR Toolkit. Let's have a look at OpenComposite. When you download OpenComposite, you get a zip file that you can unzip to any folder you want. I placed it here under my hard drive, Daten E, Spiele, OpenComposite, and in there there's a number of files, and most importantly, there's the OpenComposite exe. You can, for example, make also a shortcut that you place on a desktop. Open this exe file, and you get this view. To use OpenXR via OpenComposite, it needs to look like this. You have to press that field here until it's grayed out. This means that OpenComposite will be used and it will bypass SteamVR. Let's now create the OpenComposite .ini file to configure OpenComposite. We have to go to the local folder of Dirt Rally 2. So open Steam, select Dirt Rally, and then you can right click and select Manage to browse local files. It will open a folder. In this folder, we will create the OpenComposite .ini. So right click, New, and create here text document. So we can call it OpenComposite TXT at first, and then we open it. Windows Editor will open. We enter here hidden mesh vertical scale equals 0.8. Please make sure to use the capital letters as I'm using here and to write all letters without spaces here. Then we save and we close the file. It's still here called opencomposite.txt. So we rename it, but now we replace the .txt by .ini. There's an alert message whether you want to change the filename extension. Are you sure you want to change it? Yes, we're sure. Job done. Just leave this folder open as we will also use it in the next step for the eye accommodation fix. Next thing is the eye accommodation fix. This one will give a more realistic representation of the perception of light in your eyes. First, we need an internet browser or Firefox or Chrome, whatever. In the description of the video, you will find this link here to the DR2 VR fix for OpenXR by Mbukia. Please make sure that you use this version of the eye accommodation fix. There are also other versions out there that are intended for SteamVR, but we need the one for OpenXR. On this site here, you can download it, and once you do this, you will be getting a zip file. This zip file we copy to our still opened Dirt Rally 2 folder. I have already prepared this, and you can see it's here. dr2vrfix/openxr.zip. We will extract it exactly into this folder. It creates four files. This file here, this file, and the readme.txt. In the next step, we will be working with the dr2vrfix.config. Again, we need to go to the internet. On Reddit, there's a nice post with already adapted settings of the VR accommodation fix. I need to say, within this Reddit post, there's also a link towards the accommodation fix, and that relates to my previous warning. Don't use that one. Use the other one before for OpenXR. We just extract what is in this code section here. So, we copy this full code section. And now we go back to the folder and we open here the config file. We mark the full content. We delete it. And now we paste the content that we copied from Reddit. We're saving. We close the file and that's it. Our eye accommodation fix is also ready. Now we can move forward in the next section towards the in-game settings and the OpenXR toolkit settings. We have now started Dirt Rally 2 in VR mode and we're in the main menu. You probably have noticed the triangle animation when the game was loaded. If this animation is blue and white triangles, everything went well and you are now in OpenXR mode. If the animation was black-white triangles, you're still stuck in SteamVR mode. If this happened, please carefully check the Open Composite sections of the video again, because then something has gone wrong. Let's first go to the in-game graphics settings. So, basic graphics section, you see multi-sampling and anisotropic filtering are both turned off. We're using those via the NVIDIA driver. Let's go to advanced graphics. Here I'm selecting a custom preset. So, shader detail stays on high, texture detail as well, reflections are set to low because they eat a lot of frames per second. Screen space reflections are only visible in replay mode and shadows are set to ultra low. It's important to not turn off shadows because otherwise the immersion is strongly compromised. However, they eat a lot of performance as well. So that's why we keep them at a minimum level. Night lighting stays at medium. Ambient occlusion is off. Advanced ambient occlusion also off. Particles are low. Advanced blending is off. Weather is set to high. Crowd to medium. Cloth is set to low. Mirrors are set to low. Vehicle details work on medium. Track details work on medium, objects as well medium, trees go with medium, ground cover also medium. Skid marks are off, God rays on, and chromatic aberration is on. Plume is also on, and light streaks are on, as well as lens dust, which is turned on. That's it for the in-game settings. Of course, when you have a different graphic card than I'm using, like a strong 4090, you can play around here and get more visual candy out of the game. Last section is the OpenXR toolkit. Open it with Ctrl F2. Again, if this one is not opening, it's a strong indicator that your game is not running in OpenXR yet and still stuck in SteamVR. As mentioned before, consult the Open Composite section to make sure that your game is running properly in OpenXR mode. Since you haven't been modifying the game yet before, it's probably still looking different than for me. So let's adapt it. First go to the menu section. There we turn on the Show Expert Settings, pressing them to Yes.
For the sake of the video, I also removed the menu timeout and I shifted here with the horizontal and vertical offset the position of the overlay. Now it's denoted here by this yellow letters overlay position. Let's go to the performance tab. I'm using here as an overlay the FPS counter and I make it here show a target frame rate of 90. This is due to me using HP Reverb G2. Upscaling sharpening I set to CAS with a sharpness of 70%. For fixed foveated rendering we go with custom. Inner ring size is 55%. Middle resolution 1/4, outer ring size 80%, and outer resolution 1 divided by 16. We prefer the horizontal resolution at a horizontal scale of 150% and a vertical offset of 15%. No left-right bias and turbo mode experimental stays off. I'm not exactly sure and it's not super consistent, but the game seems to be less twitchy when it's turned off. Frame rate throttling stays off and we do not record statistics. So let's move to the next tab, to appearance. Post-processing stays off and world scale I set to 120%. You can check on my channel, there's a video about the importance of world scale in VR. Actually, one may say 100% should feel like real world scale, but to me 120% feels much better and it makes it much easier for me to judge distances. Let's go to inputs. Nothing's changed there. Let's further go to system. So overwide resolution stays off, so we're not changing any resolution. We stay with default on motion reprojection, color gains we don't change, and for field of view we chose the advanced option. On the up and on the down we crop off 10% each, setting the values to 90%. The left and right values stay at 100%. And that's already it. With all these settings we've now been improving the visual experience of Dirt Rally 2 in VR quite a lot. We can now have a final look at racing on the tracks, and while you are seeing this final showcase study, I wish you a lot of fun with my settings. I hope you enjoyed the content and I see you soon on track.
Fünf, vier, drei, zwei, eins, los. 50, 6 links über Kuppe, in 6 rechts über Kuppe, extra lang. 30, 4 rechts, in 6 links über Kuppe, extra lang. Mach zu 3 über Kuppe. In Cut, 3 rechts lang, macht auf. 6 über Kuppe, 30, 6 links über Kuppe lang, Achtung, 30, Gabel, 4 rechts durch sehr enges Tor und Kuppe in 6 rechts lang, Wasser, 30, 4 links über Kuppe in Cut, 4 rechts lang, in Cut, 5 links, langsam, 30, Gabelcut, 4 links, in Kehre rechts, umballen. 50, 6 links, 120, über Brücke eng, 4 rechts, 6 links lang, mach zu, don't cut, Gabel 3, 30, 4 rechts, über Kuppe lang, in 4 links lang, über Kuppe, 100, rechts. rechts, extra lang, Mach zu 5. Über Kuppe, extra, extra lang, Mach zu 3. 30, Cut, 4 links, über Kuppe lang. In 5 rechts, über Kuppe, Mach zu 30. 5 rechts, über Welle, bei Schild, Cut, 4 links. In 5 rechts lang, 80. Gabel, 3 rechts, verdeckt, lang. Macht auf, über Kuppe und Kuppe, 50. Kuppe 4 links lang, Mach zu, don't cut. Macht auf, über Kuppe. In 6 links, über Kuppe, 50. Und 5 links, in Achtung, 3 rechts, Mach zu, über Kuppe. In langsam, 5 links lang, über Kuppe. 30 Gabel, 3 rechts, verdeckt lang, Mach zu, eng. Macht auf lang, über Kuppe, in Achtung, eng, 3 links, über Kuppe. In 6 rechts und 3 links lang, in 4 rechts, über Kuppe. In langsam, 4 links lang, Mach zu, Abzweig, 2 links, Macht auf, lang. Und 4 rechts, Macht auf, über Kuppe, 30. 5 links, Übersprung, 30. 6 rechts, über Kuppe, 30, langsam. 4 links lang, Mach zu, Abzweig, 2. In Abzweig, 1 rechts, umballen, 50, über Kuppe. 6 links, in 5 rechts lang, Macht auf über Kuppe, 50. 4 rechts über Sprünge, in Don't Cut, 4 links lang. Macht auf über Kuppe, 30 Abzweig spät, kehre links. Und voll 6 rechts lang, 130. Mittig halten über Kuppe, in 6 rechts über Ziel, 100 bis Stopp.